Hi, all. Today, I want to talk on the age-old topic of mindfulness, because I think mindfulness can have a lot of misperceptions. Mindfulness can be seen as the practice of being in the moment, but what does this actually mean? Does it mean that if we're mindful, we should never think about the past or the future? We should never try to plan or to reflect on our past experiences? Well, actually, being in the moment means being mindfully aware of what is going on right here and now in our experience. And this includes any thinking we do about the past or the future. You see, much of the time, our experience does not have this quality of awareness or mindfulness. A lot of the time, we are like robots, automatically living out our habitual patterns of self-pity, anger, wish fulfillment, and fear. These habitual tendencies take us over and run our lives for us without our being able to stand back and decide whether this is what we actually want to be doing. It can be a real shock when we start to realize just how habitual and automatic our lives are, and when we realize how much runaway thinking leads to states of suffering. Being in the moment is just another way of saying that we are aware of what is going on in our experience. That we are not just being angry, but that we are aware that we are angry, and we are aware that we can choose to be otherwise. Of course, a lot of the time when we are not being in the moment, we are literally thinking about the past or the future. We might be dwelling on the past, brooding about some hurt or pain. We may be fantasizing about a future in which we have won the lottery and living out our lives in some imagined paradise, or just daydreaming without being in the perfect situation or the perfect partner. Often, these fantasized past and futures are not even real possibilities, but simply fantasies of how things might be or how we would have liked them to have been. In fact, we can say these are the artifacts of the untrained mind. And as with all unmindful activity, we have no awareness that this fantasizing is actually pointless. So reflect on that. There are, of course, ways of mindfully thinking about the past or the future. Being in the moment does not mean that we are stuck in the moment. We can mindfully and creatively call to mind past events or imagine what might happen in the future. We can think about the past and think about how we might have acted differently or wonder why something happened the way it did. You see, we can think about possible futures and of how those actions that we commit to now will make those futures more or less likely. When we are thinking about the past or the future while being in the moment, we are conscious that we are redirecting and reflecting, and we're not lost in the thought. We don't confuse fantasy with reality. We don't stray from thinking about the past in order to construct imaginary past in which we said or did the right thing. Or if we do so, then it's part of a conscious thought experiment to see what we might learn from the experience. We think about the future, but rather than it being idle daydreaming, we're thinking about the consequences of our actions, or otherwise reflecting on where we want to go in life. Sometimes daydreaming can be creative. It can be wonderful to relax the reins of consciousness and allow our creative minds and unconsciousness the opportunity to express itself. But it's generally far more useful to have a part of our conscious mind standing by, observing, watching for any sign that the creative expression of the unconscious is turning gray, turning into the repetitive and reactive expressions of the old and unhelpful emotional patterns. The conscious mind can intervene at such moments with a light touch, a gentle redirecting of our mental energies so that we stay in the present, aware, mindful, and creative. So as you go through your days, be aware of this, be aware of mindfulness. Understand the roles it can play. And when you sit on the cushion and meditate, understand how your past and future can play out. Use those to your advantage, and you'll grow wiser every day. As always, peace and love, Jim.